The Demolition of the Copperstack. In 2018, Vale celebrated the completion of the $1 billion Clean Air Project, a project that was one of the largest environmental investments in Ontario history at the time, and reduced emissions and improved air quality. Under the Clean Air Project, two smaller 450-foot stacks were constructed to capture SO2 and significantly reduce our carbon output and atmospheric emissions. It was an engineering and environmental success for the Sudbury region, province, and country. As a result of this project, two highly visible and well-known assets were no longer needed, the Copperstack and the Superstack. After many years of studies, evaluations, and consideration, we are now ready to safely dismantle the concrete shell of the Superstack and Copperstack, beginning with the Copperstack. Preparing for dismantling. A lot of preparation takes place for a project of this magnitude. We've mobilized expert teams who planned the processes, conducted engineer assessments, and developed mitigation plans. We've created safe work plans for every step of the way, including hazard assessments and rescue plans. How it's going to happen. The flue which fed the copper stack with emissions from the copper circuit was removed in March of 2024, and asbestos was safely removed in June 2024. That means all that remains is the concrete structure. The entire base area of the copper stack is fenced off in a plan to protect the worksite and surrounding operations of the Copper Cliff Smelter, as regular company business will not stop during this demolition. An exclusion zone on the surface is strictly controlled for everyone's safety. To begin, an opening is created at the base of the stack. It measures 35 feet high and 10 feet wide, and is used to remove debris through the operation of a long-reach excavator. When the opening is not used for excavation, it is sealed up again to prevent wind going up the stack, eliminating blowing dust. Next, a mast climber is erected along the sides of the 450-foot structure. This rail mast climber operates like an elevator and will travel along the circumference of the stack. The top of the mast climber is the summit zone, a platform where all the work happens. The demolition process involves concrete crunchers and breakers that will be operated by approximately 6 people and 2 demolition robotic excavators. The demolition will occur with 6 feet of structure broken down at a time. Debris will be discarded down the interior of the stack. The opening at the base will be sealed completely when debris is falling down the interior of the stack, and water misting will occur to suppress dust. The average size of the debris falling down the inside of the stack is the size of a basketball. As concrete gets chipped away, the working platform is disassembled in the process, and gradually, the mast climber's overall height gets reduced as the project progresses. Safely removing debris. Every 5 to 10 days, demolition will pause at the summit zone for 1 day for the unloading of debris from the base of the interior of the stack. During this period, no people are permitted to be at the summit zone working on platforms high above. All removed debris will be safely discarded, meeting regulatory standards. The concrete shell will be removed from the smelter area and placed in a designated area within Vale's central tailings facility. This location is designed for this purpose and will ensure that the rubble is safely contained, monitored, and that all contact water is treated. Anticipated completion. By November 2024, we plan to be at the 300-foot level. When the temperature outside drops to 0 degrees Celsius, work will be paused due to the potential freezing of water used to mist for dust suppression. We do not want ice building up on or near the work platform and exterior of the stack. Work can resume when temperatures are above freezing. No demolition work will occur during the winter months. As temperatures rise in spring 2025, we'll continue the work, and by the fall, we expect the project to be completed. Farewell to the Copper Stack. Our commitment to safety is at the core of who we are and drives our decisions every day. The dismantling of the Copper Stack marks the beginning of the next chapter in Vale's ongoing effort to modernize our operations. As for the Super Stack, We are currently evaluating the approach to its dismantling, and we will keep the community informed as our plans develop. For more information on the dismantling of both stacks, visit our dedicated webpage for this project